Hey, I'm Lex Friedman with TechHive. We're here in Bedminster, New Jersey at AT&T's GNOC, its Global Network Operations Center. This is where they monitor all the traffic on their network, voice, data, cellular, everything. We're gonna go inside and see exactly how they do it. Hey, Chuck, thanks for having me.
Welcome aboard, Lex. Good to have you here.
So what is the GNOC for? What do you do here?
We monitor and surveil all of AT&T's global networks, whether it's at a regional level in Ohio, it could be a domestic, a long distance level across the nation, or globally in England, if you will. We're looking for any infractions in the network, loss and delay characteristics in the data network. We're looking for blocked calls in the telephone network, and we're looking for any issues that could occur in the mobility network.
So you're covering data, voice, all the signals that AT&T
has. Data, voice, and transport, yes.
There are a ton of displays in this room. Are people actively looking at them at all times?
There are our dashboard. They watch those boards day in and night, and they'll watch more than one as well. They may look at three or four and do a correlation activity and come up with an issue that's somewhere in the network. When the tsunamis hit, or the earthquake in Japan, we were able to very quickly see, almost instantly, we had blocked calls occurring in the Western Pacific. At the same time, we had loss and delay characteristics in the Western Pacific for the internet. And we took and received an email from the U.S. Geological Survey that said there was a 9.2 earthquake. And we took boom, 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 and correlated all those and began to communicate to our executives that we had a problem. And we put all of our processes in place and began to execute. So these are very real. They look great. They serve a purpose as far as, you know, giving us a view across many different disciplines that we can correlate very quickly and then drill down at our positions.
There are also television displays on here. Why is that?
Those are the eyes to the world. It's very important to understand what's causing any issues with the network itself. During the Super Bowl, we can tell when everybody's watching the game. And then when it's halftime, you see a drop or an increase depending on what you're looking at.
So you can sort of tell which commercials are the best by how much extra internet traffic comes up?
I wish we could.
What could somebody do if they were in here who wasn't supposed to be in here, if I'm looking at this data?
You can manage and manipulate all the voice traffic globally for AT&T. If you execute the correct command, you could pretty well bring that to a stop.
That would not be good.
Not good at all.
Has there been an incredible ramp up in data consumption that you're measuring here over the past few years as smartphones ascend?
Absolutely. We're seeing, you know, if you build it, they will come. Each day, the yellow line, you'll see it increase higher and higher and higher. And at the same time, you know, within the CBB itself, the backbone, the internet backbone, a lot of the traffic that we push across there from our mobility network, you can see that begin to expand as well. During the business week, we watch the boards and they'll give you a very clear ramp up day over day of the traffic as people come online at work. The networks mimic human nature. If, you know, everybody's heading for the weekend and want to get out because it's a 3-day weekend and get out early, the traffic drops off as well.
Now, I've been here a couple hours and various issues have appeared to come up and been resolved within 15 minutes to 45 minutes.
Right.
Is that an everyday occurrence? Things are always breaking?
Yeah, it's a big network. There's never, ever a dull moment just because of the sheer size of the network.
Is there an element to the job that makes it thankless? People only notice when something's going wrong?
Hey, when it's quiet, that's good. And when you don't know, that's even better. We're very proud of that.
Well, Chuck, thanks so much for taking the time to talk to us. This was great.
It's been an absolute pleasure. You're more than welcome to come back anytime.
All right, I'll be here tomorrow.
Good. We'll have a job for you.